the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Drew Anderson.
As we take a look at the National Radar Loop on Super Doppler 8, there is the disturbance that brought some snow to Maryland in the overnight hours, pushing off the coast very quickly, too, thanks to dry air. But as we take a look close to home here, all quiet on live Super Doppler 8 this morning. Temperatures, they're pretty close to 30 degrees, so still another chilly morning, but not quite as chilly as yesterday morning because of all the cloud cover we did start the day with. Now the sunshine has certainly moved out, and throughout the rest of the day, we will become mostly sunny. But still a very chilly day. Temperatures only going up 10 more degrees to 38 to 42. Then tonight, a clear and a very chilly night. 18 to 24, some spots dipping into the teens, particularly in those low valleys around the Susquehanna Valley. Then tomorrow, the clear skies do stick around for another sunny day, and our highs a bit higher, 42 to 46, but a brisk day with breezes from the northwest at 10 to 15 miles an hour. Now let's go outside to the city of Harrisburg and see those clearing skies on the horizon. And also, too, I do want to check conditions. It is 29 degrees right now, but the wind chill, even those light breezes from the north, pulling in some of that drier air, does make the temperature feel in the low 20s when you're stepping outside. The humidity is at 44%, and that's a relatively low number, and particularly it was low throughout the evening, which is the reason we didn't see any snow move up from the south. Now taking a look at temperatures across the region, close to 30 around our area, the influence of colder air extending far to the south. That's because the jet stream is far to the south, allowing that cold air to move in. We'll take a look over the last 12 hours. There's the low pressure system primarily based to the south, and it was a disturbance from an upper level low that brought some of that snow just south of us. But that disturbance and the low pressure system rapidly moved off the coast. It is just leaving now a few systems, and I should say a few storms that are strengthening in the south. For us, high pressure moving in, helping to push out those clouds and take them out of the Susquehanna Valley and leave us with high pressure throughout the rest of the day. High pressure will be sticking around throughout the next few days. So here on Predictor, I did put a few isobars. These are lines of equal pressure. Anytime these lines do get close together, it's a little bit breezy, and we'll see that as we head toward Monday. So taking a look here, also our airflow will follow these pressure lines, so continue to come in from the northwest to keep us chilly over the next few days as well, but some gorgeous days as high pressure just sits over us and continues to build into Monday. Those pressure lines do creep together just a bit on Monday, so we'll be a bit breezy between some high pressure and some low pressure far to the north. Then on Tuesday, high pressure does continue. However, a storm system is developing in parts of the plains in the Midwest. That won't affect us as we head into the day on Wednesday because high pressure will be strong enough to keep that system away for the entirety on Tuesday. So Wednesday, some increasing clouds as a result of that system moving in. But as for today, a gorgeous day, but still unseasonably cool. 43 for the high today. Down into the 20s tonight, some spots into the teens for one very chilly night. And taking a look on to Monday, 44 for the high with mostly sunny skies. Also the case on Tuesday, and a high just a bit above 44 to 48 degrees. But those lows staying chilly with clear skies over both Monday night and into Tuesday night. Then clouds on the way for Wednesday. Could see a few p.m. showers. Might even see a few snowflakes mix in Wednesday night into early Thursday, but it would just be some wet snowflakes and it would be brief. Some rain ending on Thursday before another system delivers some more rain on Friday, but this active weather at the end of the week is a good thing because it'll give us a slight pattern change to help our temperatures not only get up toward the 50s for the end of the week, but hopefully to keep going, and that's the way it does look.
I'm just looking forward to a week that doesn't have snow in the forecast anywhere.
You know, I think a lot of people are in that consensus as well.
I think so. Thank you very much, Drew.